This video series contains scientific and medical concepts aimed at informing healthcare professionals. Please note that the videos may contain visually stimulating images and movement.
The cause of post-exertional malaise is not fully understood, but it's not from deconditioning. PEM is not a psychological disorder, and so reconditioning or graded exercise is not appropriate for these patients. Graded exercise meaning fixed or preset advances in frequency, duration, intensity will only make post-exertional malaise worse. Post-exertional malaise is a worsening of symptoms after exertion. Exertion can include physical, orthostatic, cognitive, emotional,
sensory, and environmental stressors.
It's the hallmark feature of myalgic encephalomyelitis, or ME-CFS. And it's also being seen in a subset of patients who are recovering from COVID.
Therapists need to be aware that some of the stressors are not even something that they're recognizing. It might be the lights in the room or the noise in the background that are triggering stressors.
PEM can be delayed for 12 to 72 hours. Sometimes it's immediate, but usually it's delayed. And so that's often the hard thing for therapists to recognize, is when they have a session with a patient, they may not realize until the next time they see that patient that their therapy session caused post-exertional malaise, and that patient didn't experience that worsening of symptoms until 12 to 72 hours later. That's also hard for patients to recognize because it's so delayed that they often don't attribute that post-exertional malaise to the activity because it was the day before or 2 days before.
Patients who are experiencing PEM are not avoiding or not scared of doing activity. They are actually feeling their body's response to the exertion. So they are actually recognizing their body and taking cues for their exertion or their stressors. They have the motivation, they have the desired. Their body's just shutting down before they're able to complete. So there's a premature exit of the activity.
Yeah, I always say patients or people want to do activities. If they're not doing it, it's not because they're lazy or deconditioning. It's because they are unable to. When they feel good enough, they will increase their activities. And most patients with post-exertional malaise want to do more. Their body just doesn't allow them to.
This video was made possible by the OMF-funded Medical Education Resource Center at BHC, our generous donors and viewers like you. Please consider making a tax-deductible donation to help keep educational resources like this one publicly available.